I often find myself having limited time, a packed schedule, many things to attend to, a lot of repertoire to cover. So in order to manage to do everything necessary during my practice time, I need to make sure that I'm as efficient and effective as possible. In this video, I'm going to share with you four of the things that have helped me immensely to keep my productivity up both during my time on and off the piano. What's up guys, Evgeny Genchev here with another Swiss struggle video, sharing with you my experience and knowledge both as a performer and as a teacher to help you on your path as a musician. No worries, because I got you covered. Before we get to the essence of this video, I thought it is essential to actually define what are the things that keep us from being as productive as we can be on a daily basis. What is most frequently the case is that there might be some time management issues or maybe some organizational problems. Or perhaps you get easily distracted and you let yourself drift away. Perhaps you avoid challenging tasks because they seem maybe too grand or too difficult to start. I've got a little something for all of these problems, so let's get into it. First of all, you need to map out your plan. Make a list, daily, weekly, or even monthly. It can be also a mental list, but in my experience, writing things down actually helps you keep yourself accountable. Know what you're gonna practice, what you're trying to achieve during that practice, and approximately how long would it take you to achieve this. You can be as detailed as you want. Just make sure that you don't spend more time on making the list rather than actually doing the work. Once you're done for the day, make sure that you write down what you have done, what you have exceeded, and what you did not manage to do. Try to log in everything that you have done for the day. That will allow you to keep yourself accountable when at the end of the week or at the end of the month, you see what has gone well and what has been lagging. Personally, even in my most productive days, I tend to overestimate a little bit on how much I can do. And that's okay. Don't beat yourself up just because you didn't manage to do everything that was on the list. An important thing to remember here though, is that you need to set your priorities. What are the big tasks that you need to achieve? And what are the minor things that are gonna take less energy and time? What is actually urgent? And what can wait until tomorrow? To address another problem of productivity, here is my tip number two. We all play music because we really love it. At least, I hope you do. Something about the music resonating from under your fingers and you being able to shape it, it just gives you such a huge kick. And I think it is safe to assume that most of the time we actually play things that we really like, that really move us, that we cannot get enough of. And this is amazing and it is essential because in order to give the best possible performance that you can, you need to care dearly for the music that you play. But all this can actually cause a huge problem in productivity when you need to practice it. I have faced this problem so many times. I would start the practice session and instead of drilling a place that really needs to be worked out, I would end up just playing through the piece poorly, over and over again, which was both frustrating because obviously I was just messing it up and I was doing a poor job in playing it. And on top of that, it was counterproductive because I was just gathering more and more wrong habits. To avoid all this, here is a tool that I use to tackle this productivity problem. And this is practicing with a timer. How does this work? You need to take a timer, set it up to 1 minute, and then start practicing. In 60 seconds, inevitably the timer is gonna start ringing. You can treat that as your wake-up call. At the end of each 60 seconds, you need to ask yourselves a couple of questions. What am I doing? And am I doing what I should be doing? It reminds you to practice and not just play, and it keeps you from drifting away, turning into a poetry class over here. Let's just say that rhythm is important both in speech and in music. So, the timer keeps you conscious. It keeps you aware on what you need to do and it keeps you more responsible for what you do. So, as soon as the 60 seconds run out, repeat it. The first time I used this My mind exploded from the intensity it was held to, and I had a super productive session. Now, once you get used to 60 seconds and your focus span improves, you can then increase it to 90 seconds, then even to 2 minutes. I would warn you though to not rush getting to 2 minutes. You may ask, but this keeps cutting me off in the middle of my passage. It's like, OMG, like it's so annoying. Like, seriously? Do I need to make it longer? Can I just make it longer? Come on. Yeah. Then, my dear, I do need to ask you this question. Are you practicing or are you playing through? If you're dealing with a difficult passage, then you can take it one bar at a time, two bars, four bars at a time. It is generally plenty. I promise you, this will boost your productivity through the roof. You can find plenty of apps that have the timer option, and I'm sure that your devices also have it as a native app. So make sure you give it a try and you use it. Now, that takes me to the third tip that I've got for you today, and that is, don't practice with devices around you.
But you just... What? You just said apps? How?
First of all, there are timers that are not related to your phone or tablet. You can use a clock or even an old-fashioned cooking timer. There are many ways that you can do things if you're willing. And if you're watching this, I assume you are. So get yourself one of those and roll with it. You know you can do it. And it makes a huge difference when you don't see this shiny notification illuminating your phone every 2 minutes. Although, if they come that regularly, you might even use it as a timer. Tip number four on helping you to be more productive is playing backwards. Not literally backwards, but just let me explain, okay? You know how we have a tendency to play through the easier stuff first, and then we just glide through these hard passages because, well, it makes us uncomfortable. It's difficult. We don't really want to get into it. You might be already aware of this, you might already have your own experience of this, but let me just remind you. Hard passages, hard places in the music take longer to learn. It takes longer for them to settle in your mind, in your memory, and in the physicality of your hands. So when you are improving all the rest and you keep avoiding those, you're basically working against yourself. You always need to attack the difficult places first. Scout through the piece, listen to a recording while you're checking out the score, and figure out where these places are. Then start with them. I remember when I got to play the Schumann Fantasy, the first place that I started learning was the ending of the second movement. Because I knew in this half an hour piece, this is gonna be the place that takes the longest to settle down. And then I never really had a major problem with it during the performance because it was at the same level as everything else. Now, if you're uncertain where to start from, always start from the ending and make your way to the beginning, taking it bar by bar. And no, I don't literally mean turning the score upside down or playing backwards. Guys, I thought we had already cleared that. Like, seriously, like, okay? So when you start, do the last few bars first, then add a few, then a few more, and at some point you will reach the beginning of the piece. That will actually also help you greatly with not getting carried away in playing. Because essentially, once we reach the end of the score, we have nowhere else to go. We need to just go back to the beginning of the passage that we're practicing. You can use this method anywhere and everywhere. It is really magical. And combined with a timer, it's gonna just break all records of productivity. Back in my school days, my classmates used to joke with me about this. At first, I couldn't play any piece from the start. I could play just the endings. This happened once that my teacher was entering the school and overheard me practicing. This was one of the corner rooms of the school, so whenever someone would exit or enter the school, they would pass by it, which was kind of annoying, but this was my favorite room to practice in. It had this beautiful old Bechstein, which had such a beautiful mechanics and such a rich and mellow sound. Just mwah, so good. That's why, guys, when I tell you that collaborating with Bechstein has a big sentimental value to me, I'm not messing around. My childhood wouldn't be the same without this instrument. So back to the story, later that afternoon, my teacher asked me if I could play the first movement of the concerto that she overheard me practicing. She naturally presumed that, well, if he's playing the ending of the concerto, he must know the whole thing. To her disappointment, I only could play the third movement and the cadenza. So to recap, guys, in order to boost your productivity, make sure you make a plan, prioritize it, and log in all your activity to allow yourself to keep track of things and keep yourself accountable. Use a timer to help you with your focus. Try to limit any access to devices in order to avoid distractions. And make sure you address the most challenging things first rather than putting them on snooze. And actually, one last thing as a bonus reminder for you. There is no substitution for practice. Unless you sit down and put in the work, nobody else is gonna do it for you. And nobody can actually learn the piece instead of you. So no matter how productive you are, if you spend insufficient time with your instrument, then there won't be sufficient progress. So make the time and put in the time. So I hope you found this useful, guys. And remember that unless you put practice as the first thing on this list, your progress is not gonna be as quick as you like. At the end of the day, whether it's on piano or violin or anything else in life, we practice in order to progress, to improve and develop ourselves. So I hope this helps you to achieve what you're striving for. I hope it gives you a few more tools to tackle any issues you may have. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. If you've got any questions, let me know down in the comments below. And subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.